I'm so glad that you're back with us today. This is Temple Baptist Church Online Devotions. And as I'm continuing and talking about growing and being a better disciple of Jesus, today what I'm going to be talking about is transformation. Growing into a better disciple of Jesus takes transformation. And transformation is a thorough and dynamic change in some area of one's life. You know what the Transformers are, probably. Those movies have been around for quite some time. You've seen superhero movies where people like the Hulk transform into from a normal-looking man into a green giant and other types of things like that. We're not talking about something that's make-believe. We're talking about transforming from being the way that we were before our relationship with Christ to being the way that God desires for us to be, and that is Christ-like in every area of our life. Paul had a huge desire for believers in Rome, both Gentile and Jewish believers, and that desire was for them to be transformed into a Christ-likeness that would glorify God the Father. This is what Paul says in Romans chapter 12, verses 1 and 2. He says, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service, and do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. So to be transformed in this case is to no longer be like we were, but to be moving forward toward a Christ-likeness that proves God's power at work in our lives and in the life of anyone that would choose to give their heart to Him and to be followers of Jesus. Look at the words that he chooses to use here. First of all, he says, I beseech you. That is that I plead with you from the depths of my heart. This is important, and I really want you to get it. I want you to experience what I have experienced. I beseech you. Then he says, by the mercies of God, understanding that it's not by the will of man or the power of man or the initiative of man that we'll be able to make any of these transformative changes on our own, but it's through God's mercy that He works in our life to transform us into a Christ-like model of Jesus that glorifies Him. Then he goes on to say that you present your bodies a living sacrifice. You do what only you can do, and that is to lay your life before God the Father, saying, Lord, I can't change myself. I can't transform myself. I can't make myself over. I don't have the power to be perfect on my own and to be as Christ-like as I would desire to be. And so I lay my life on the altar and I ask you to transform me in the way that you would desire, in the way that you would desire. And what God desires is that we not be conformed to this world, but that we're conformed to Christ-likeness, that we're conformed to what we would see at some point in heaven. And so he goes on to say that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service. And do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. And so do not be conformed to this world, knowing that your life belongs to God. God's desire for you and for I is that we die to the things of this world so that we can live to the things of heaven. Jesus told his disciples often, seek first the kingdom of God. Set your mind upon the things that are in heaven. And everything else, God will take care of that. God will take care of that. Then he uses this word to be transformed. To be transformed is to experience the transformation which only the Lord can bring about. Only God can make this transformation within our lives. We can't do it ourselves. And then he says, by the renewing of your mind. And so as we give our whole life over mind, body, and soul to God, and we focus completely on these things, the Spirit of God begins to move and work within us so that we begin to see those changes so that we become like Jesus. And then lastly, he says, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. And so as we're transformed, we prove what God has said all along, that he's holy and right, that he's merciful, that he is just, that he's loving and patient and kind, that he is gracious with us. The result of God's transforming power in our life is that our life becomes the proof of all that he is and all that he does in a person's heart, soul, and mind. At Temple Baptist Church, we want to help you grow in this way. Come and join us on Sundays at 8 or 10 a.m., 6 p.m., and or Wednesdays at 7 p.m. Come and join us as we grow in Christ together and experience his transformative power at work in us. God bless you and have a good day.